Consultant General Surgeon Goldie Khera now talks about fad diets with Mark Walker.
So I'm here with Goldie Khera, who's a Consultant General Surgeon at Montefiore Hospital, Ball Sussex County Hospital. Welcome back. Happy New Year as well.
Happy New Year.
So we're going to be talking about fad diets. They're a big thing, aren't they? Every single year people say they're going to do a diet. Doesn't always last forever. So what's the do's and don'ts in dieting?
No, I think every time you talk to a patient or you scroll on the internet or anything, this is the time. January's the time. So fad diets, so whatever you want to call them, whether you know there's a name to them, or whether they're the cabbage soup diet or you know any Atkins diet, there are basically all of them associated with health dangers. It's because you're not having a balanced diet, because you're excluding lots and lots of food groups. So that's mainly the issue. So they are fad diets for those reasons. So what I wanted to talk about is essentially just the dangers of doing something which you're not going to sustain. You can't stay on juiced cabbage forever.
Yeah.
It'd be awful if you did. It's not sustainable, and it'd be dangerous for you health-wise if you did.
Yeah.
I think the health damage that you can create for yourself, for vitamin nutrition, all sorts of minerals that you'd lose, protein, all of the balanced diet that you should have, none of that is being supported by a fad diet. So you may actually lose a little bit of weight, and in fact, you probably will lose a little bit of weight. But the issue is that it's not sustainable. You're then going to have a rebound weight gain. So actually, at the end of that 4-week, 6-week period, you're probably going to weigh more if that's your outcome. You're not going to be healthier because you're going to be deficient of stuff. So all in all, it's a great internet scam as far as I can see.
Yeah.
And I think, but we shouldn't really be promoting it. And patients do ask me if it's a good idea or a healthy idea, and it's definitely not. So I think by being healthy, by being outside, by being outdoor activities, by cycling, by walking, or going to the gym and having a balanced, healthy diet, and we talked about it before, by having smaller portion sizes, that's the key, and making small changes rather than literally just having beetroot for 4 weeks or cabbage for 4 weeks or whatever the latest paleo diet is. I mean, there's thousands. We could hear it for hours, thousands of those. And that's the issue where they are fad, and it's for a reason.
Is it? Can you just lose a lot of weight very fast? Because some people say, well, you can binge eat for 2 days. But that does seem, I've no cases where that has worked, where you kind of just don't massively cut down the calorie intake, but then maybe binge eat for 2 days and then, I mean, I have heard of that working. For example, reversing diabetes. You know, people say you can reverse diabetes, but you have to drastically cut your calorie count down.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about if you're cutting down your calorie count and if you incorporate it into healthy diet when you are eating and you're doing exercise, then that's fine. That wouldn't be that wouldn't be a problem. That would be a sustained change in your life. Excellent, fantastic. But I think the actual starvation aspect or sticking to one food group aspect, that's where it gets dangerous. But luckily, it's not sustainable. But I'm just trying to make you aware, that's all.
Yes, all right. Mm. One thing is, eating late at night, does that make a difference or not? Because there's mixed opinions on...
I think it does. I think it's quite easy to do that. I mean, I'm often doing that after, you know, shifts at work.
Yeah.
So it's a big problem, and it does give you heartburn, and it's not, I think, good for your metabolism anyway. So as a general rule, you should have, you know, bigger lunch and a smaller light dinner.
Is breakfast always that most important meal?
I think so.
Or is lunch more important now? Because it always used to be breakfast is the key one.
I think breakfast is the key one. And I think if you're having a healthy breakfast, I think that's the thing to do.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good to me. All right, thanks for coming in.
Cheers, thank you.
Thanks.
Yeah.